Hello everyone, I think many of you know that tungsten is a pretty tough metal. In this video, I would like to test the robustness of tungsten, because robustness and hardness are very different things. For conducting this experiment, we went to a good old shooting range, where my friends shoot any items brought by me with pleasure. Don't forget that all the experiments carried out in this video are performed by professionals. Do not try this at home. To begin with, we decided to test out regular 3mm fixed steel with bullets. I don't know for sure which type of steel this is, but let's test it out. We secured the sheet very firmly, so it will absorb most energy coming from bullets, and the distance between them is 15 meters. 9mm bullets left a couple of holes in the sheet, which means that steel is quite soft and can easily be shot with a 9mm pistol, and its robustness is really small. In order for you not to get confused, hardness is a measure of the resistance to scratches and hollows, whereas robustness is a measure of the resistance to disfigurement and destruction by the external forces. Ideally, the best material to stop bullets will perfectly combine lightness, robustness and hardness. It will absorb all the energy coming from bullets and will not get disfigured and damaged. Since steel turned out to be almost as soft as clay, I am going to use another metal, molybdenum. Its robustness is much higher than that of steel. Along with that, this metal is quite hard, but not flexible. The size of this sheet is the same as that of the previous one. That is why this experiment should be failed. Molybdenum didn't come up to my expectations. 9mm bullet easily passed through it. Evidently, I'll have to abandon my dreams about molybdenum armor. Because of the low viscosity of this metal, bullets tore out bits of metal when passing through it. One of my friends brought M4 rifle. That is why he was quite happy to fire all the bullets from his firearm clip into the molybdenum sheet. Actually, molybdenum is not even used as bullet armor. It is usually used to make crucibles or refractory items, and also as a component in hard steel. Nevertheless, it must be the first time you see someone test robustness of molybdenum by bullets on YouTube. In the end, I decided to test one of the hardest and most heavy metals, tungsten. The size of this sheet is the same as that of the previous ones. By the way, it's really expensive. This tungsten sheet costs more than $200. Interestingly, because of its high density, this sheet weighs more than 3 kilograms. And it's quite difficult to lift it off the flat table with two hands. Also, as we can see, the surface of molybdenum sheet differs from the tungsten sheet. Tungsten is more matte, whereas molybdenum is more shiny. I'm wondering how such tungsten sheets are made at the factory, as tungsten is the most refractory metal, with a melting point of more than 3000 Celsius degrees. Anyway, let us see if it can withstand 9mm bullets impact. 3, 2, 1, fire! Really, I didn't expect such results. Tungsten sheet broke to pieces, just like glass. Evidently, the hardness of this metal was not enough, as it lacked viscosity. It is worthy of note that when we put all the pieces together, we could see that the bullets were fired into one place, causing these cracks to appear. We also noticed that hardness of this metal flattened the bullets and they didn't pass through farther. Most probably, the tungsten sheet we fired at had polycrystalline structure. That is, it consisted of microscopic crystals, and that is why it was so fragile. If to grow monocrystal from tungsten with well-organized structure, the metal will get more viscous and probably it will be able to stop bullets. However, it's very difficult to find such sheets, and they are way too expensive. In the end, it became clear that it's practically impossible to make tank armor from tungsten, because it would weigh too much and will crack if just a small missile was hit it. But there is no need to be disappointed, because now you know the difference between hardness and robustness, and that some extremely heavy and hard metals, such as tungsten, have Achilles' heel, which is their breaking to pieces, just like glass. Nevertheless, tungsten is used in making some armor piercing shells and bullet cores. However, in our country, such bullets are forbidden for citizens, and that is why I used a tungsten sheet in order to test robustness of tungsten in some way. Finally, we put together the pieces of tungsten and decided to fire at them from a powerful rifle. As was expected, tungsten broke to thousands of small pieces. Some of them can be used as souvenirs. So, what conclusion we can draw after watching this video? A hard metal is not always firm. It applies to other metals too. Hopefully, now you will be able better understand the difference between robustness and hardness and properties of materials. For the provided metals for the experiments, I'll thank the company Stanford Advanced Materials. I'll put a link in the description to their site.